We have a good start of the 2021. I must say that I'm again very proud of the entire group. We are continuing to adapt and to take every challenges that we are facing due to the COVID situation. We are delivering, I would say, according to expectation or even above for all our business areas. All in all, very satisfied, and yeah, again, I'm very, very pleased with the organization.
You look happy, but do you have any particular highlights that you would share with us?
I think as a group, we are continue to grow. Obviously, there are some challenging markets out there, and there are restrictions which you know affecting us. I'm very pleased that we are, as a group, delivering book-to-bill above one, actually 1.2. Obviously, I'm also very pleased that Kongsberg Maritime continued to secure order in a very difficult situation, but also a challenging maritime market in general. I think KDI continued to roll out their digital solutions, and we see more and more, let's say, interest in their solutions also.
Speaking about orders, we have orders coming in also this quarter. Would you care to share a bit more about those?
Yeah, I think, you know, first and foremost, I think all the orders that I'm not talking about, I have highlighted some bigger contract today. I have highlighted some strategically important contract. If you look behind all the orders, 7.6 billion, there are small and medium-sized orders that we are continuously securing every day, every week, every month. Also, you know, the back office and the support team behind all these orders, I think it's important for us to remember that it is the entire value chain in Kongsberg that makes us able to continue to secure that kind of volume of orders. Yeah, I think it's important to remember that.
Yes, it's not only the headliners.
It's not only the headliners, that's for sure.
Let's return to KDI a bit. You have some news about this business area as well this quarter.
Yeah, I think, you know, as I mentioned, KDI are continuing taking solid positions in the digitalization, particularly in the maritime industry and also in the energy industry. I think now Kongsberg Digital is having a very solid foundation to continue scale that business. What we have said today is that we are assessing opportunities for a partnership with somebody. Also alternatively, we look at you know, a possible listing of KDI. That is not something that's gonna happen tomorrow. We are making that tool also available for us going forward. Then it's all about timing. The main focus for KDI and Kongsberg now is to continue you know, scaling on the foundation that they have made today.
No firm timeline, but how does our prospects look for the rest of this year?
I think, actually it looks quite good for the group as a whole. I think we are bound for growth also this year. We have said that Kongsberg Defence & Aerospace will grow. We are quite sure about that if you look at the solid backlog, and then Kongsberg Maritime, it remains to see. We see some positive signals, I would say. Remember, it coming from a very low level when it comes to new contracting. I hope that we have seen the start of the lifting of the restriction, because that will be very important for the aftermarket and the possibilities in the aftermarket in KM. Hopefully we will also see that the new building market are picking up going forward. We have seen some segments, like the container vessels, has really been peaking both end of last year, but also in Q1.
Cautious optimism and confidence for the future?
I'm cautious optimistic optimistic. Of course, I think we have to just continue to, you know, do what Kongsberg is best to do, is to continue to deliver according to customers' expectation, and then focus on our business, and then I'm quite sure that we will have a positive future for Kongsberg also in 2021 and onwards.
Thank you so much. Gyrid, we are standing here again with yet another good quarter. You are spoiling us. Can you tell us a bit about the financials?
Of course, and it's not me, it's the 11,000 employees in Kongsberg that definitely again have delivered. What we saw was that we have a decline in the top line, and we need to grow. We always need to grow to be here. But of course, in terms of COVID, the maritime area had a decrease on the top line with 16%. But then the defense area is developing quite healthy with 21% increase. And also Kongsberg Digital is contributing, even though they have the maritime simulation that also is hit by COVID. But having said that, the results are very good. The margin are again beating all the margins we have been delivering before. 13.9% for EBITDA margin for the group, and also want to point out the combined commercial marine and the Kongsberg Maritime area, which has the highest margin ever in the combined company with 11.2%. We have some guidance about the margin that we have out in the market, where we say that we will deliver 14, or aim for delivering 14% EBITDA margin at the end of 2022, combined with 16% on the defense area and 13% on the maritime area. And of course, with the margin we see in defense today, nobody believes that we will not beat that. And I can to a certain agree. I agree with that, of course, because they delivered 20% EBITDA margin this quarter and had been delivering 19.5% for the last year. But what we should be aware of is that it's a group, and the combination of the group needs to deliver 14%. So maritime needs to be on an increasing curve to be able for the whole group to deliver all that. And also in terms of cash, we still have a very healthy cash position, and it has been important for us now to get that message out that we actually are a very solid company. So I just tell everybody to go to kongsberg.com and read the new credit rating report for Kongsberg. It's have a very solid outlook, and it gives you a bit more insight in the financial situation of Kongsberg today.
We also need to speak a bit about KDI. So from a financial perspective, what's your take on that?
KDI is developing very, very healthy at the moment in terms of new contracts, new users, both and new subscriptions, both on the digital twin in terms of assets and in terms of users. What we need to address is that we have a lot of interest around KDI, and we have had that for last year at least, both in terms of why are you not listing KDI, we want also to be part of that journey with quite front runner positions that they have today. Industrial actors have been taking contact, and also financials wants to be part of do partnerships with Kongsberg in that. Having that said, it's obvious that if you look 1 year back, we didn't have the contract for Shell International, and we were still in a very, very early phase on Vessel Inside. So we needed in Kongsberg DNA to be sure that we have a better investment case, also to be able to announce KDI for a possible IPO in the future. But that's just one of the tools that we need to have in the toolbox, because KDI is very connected to Kongsberg still. So we need to do a carve out first to be able to do those things. But having said that, it's of course a very interesting investment case now. So we want to share that a bit and just announce that we are looking into this every day, how we can develop KDI in the future.
Yes, because we have received a question today saying that, well, we've looked at your in your books. Don't you have the financial muscle to develop KDI by yourselves? So any comment to that?
Yes, of course, we have a a lot of cash at the account, and we can do a lot of M&As with KDI, we can do a lot of things like that. But it's also all about paying attention. And we are a large group with a lot of business areas and a lot of things to think about. So having that as one option for KDI will maybe help us to develop that area a bit faster than we will do by ourselves. So that's what we are looking into and do evaluations around right now.
So looking at the company as a whole again, just to finish up, what's the financial prospect for this year and going forward?
Yes, I had some comments on that in my presentation. So we still believe that we will be a growth company also in 2021, even if we had 16% decrease in the top line in maritime this quarter, because KDI is developing quite healthy on the top line. But and we have seen some positive trend at the end of Q1 also for Kongsberg Maritime. So hopefully the top line would be flattish for this year, and a growth for Kongsberg Maritime and a small growth for the group.